I met Christopher Lee in a chat room on the internet. The more we began to speak, the more I began to enjoy our time, his perspective. He publishes a blog out of his dojo in Honolulu. Create a Beautiful World is happy to bring you a conversation with Christopher Lee. Christopher, thank you for being with us.
So it's important that we look at teachers as people who can give us those tools and not necessarily as exemplars of the perfect achievement. And even if they are have achieved the penultimate whatever, if you're looking to Osensei or anybody else, there's also a difficulty in that, the best achievers are not always the best coaches. You look at athletes or musicians or whoever, you might have the best athlete in the world, but he may suck big time as a coach. He can't transmit.
I took a class with Joe Pass. You know who he is, the jazz guitarist?
Yes.
Yeah, and who everyone would put in, if he wasn't the greatest, he's in the top 10 or whatever. Yeah, he was horrible as a teacher. But he did say one really great thing. He said, after he ran through a number of things, he said, but I don't know, just play it the way you play it. Yeah. That was probably the best lesson he gave.
Yeah. Well, it's great to have just exposure to those people anyway, if that's right. If that's real, right. Just to experience them, what they can do, what they're doing. But so Morihei Ueshiba, to my thinking, received a technical method from Sokaku Takeda, an intent-driven body method from Sokaku Takeda. Sokaku Takeda, of course, was a paranoid about secrecy. He didn't teach people. He said, I'm not going to teach people. He told his son, don't teach people, right? Only teach one person, don't teach them secrets. And he didn't really teach in any case, as most of his students said. That was one problem. Morihei Ueshiba tended to imitate Sokaku Takeda in many ways, and I think for that reason he was in some points less than open. It's the same thing in any physical activity, right? Or any activity that you learn for someone. Some people have different abilities. They have different amounts of time to put into it. They devote different amounts of effort to understanding it. So, of course, many of his students were quite accomplished. I think what they all had in common was that they all had a difficulty understanding the explanation. What they got almost by feel, by touch. Even Seigo Yamaguchi, who could do some really incredible things, admitted at one point that he didn't really understand how he did the things he did. Right? He learned them by watching the founder, taking ukemi from the founder, by feeling it, doing it. But he had the model right there, right? He had Morihei Ueshiba in front of him. He could study that. Then we get to their students, right? Their students are no longer feeling the original model. They're feeling a copy of the model. The explanation is unclear because people didn't understand the words, or they didn't want to understand the words. They didn't want to put in the effort. They didn't have the background for whatever reason. And so you get a gradual, like a telephone game, you get a gradual degradation of what's going on in the conversation. Right? There are more things in what Osensei said, perhaps, than are generally understood.